So I pulled up all up. Ransom didn't know how to come over here in the morning like Buddy did. So he's a little behind the power curve. Bell and a donkey came over. Here comes the old guy. So I kind of put one paw right here and I'm gonna make them eat together. Spread it out a little bit. And I'm gonna stand between Buddy so he doesn't have a chance to push him off. Come on, Ransom, it's okay. Come on. Come on. Buddy, since you pushed him off, get out of here. Come on. Come on. Buddy, don't turn around him. Come on, Bubba. So now Buddy got pushed off. It's okay, little Ransom. So Buddy's mad. It's not fun getting pushed off, huh? For no reason. Come on. Come on, it's okay, I'll let you in. Come on. Come on. He's been itching all morning on something. I don't know what's going on with him. He was itching on the front, then he itched on the way over here. Now he's just over there. Now some people say when you give worming, horses get itchy because it makes the worms come out of their hiding. See that damn donkey pushing that little donkey? Hey, you better knock it off. It's okay, little buddy. I'll give you guys some. She'll let you share with her. Now see, I moved in between them. Kind of tell them to back up a little bit. All right, come on. Come on. He's mad at me. So I'm gonna move away a little bit, give him a little space so he thinks he can come in. So he knows he got discipline. That's what he makes Ransom do. I know. So see, when I was out there earlier and I fed them the other day, I never left, so he never pushed Ransom away. And therefore, I didn't need to chase him off. He just kind of came in because they were both wanting to get fed. So he's kind of itchy on that neck. I wonder if he did have worms in a... I haven't given him that ivermectin in a while. I gave it to him yesterday. And maybe that's what's causing his itching. It's okay. Don't run over me. You can stay here. So Ransom almost kind of went over me a little bit when Buddy came in. Because he's more... Buddy? Knock it off. See that little head Bobby gave him. There's Smokey Cat over there. About a flagpole. So I do think little Ransom is getting more solid. See how kind of flabby he is? I mean, he was so flabby at first, and he's getting more muscle right here. But he was pretty flabby from not getting any exercise, not getting moved. So I noticed some people said he's putting on weight. Buddy, he's got freaking a little bit more solid. Oh, I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to correct you that time. He's like, dude, what did I do this time? You didn't do anything. Look at you, you're a muddy mess. I rubbed my hand underneath you. So I put more hay over there. So this is just a little bit of hay because I wanted them to eat together again. Here comes that damn donkey. He's going to push her off. Watch him spin his butt. So it's already gone, so he can't spin her off. I didn't bring their other hay. Hang on, Belle. I'll go get you some. Your little nose looks like it was skin up. What'd you do? So you can tell when I stand here. Give Belle a little bit more. She, damn donkey will come eat it. Here, baby girl. I know. You're a good girl. I think Buddy pushed him away while I wasn't over there. Because he moved away and I wasn't watching. So I moved closer to Buddy because he's starting to kind of give him a little bit. If you remember, him and Mr. T used to eat, but I remember when I fed him and Mr. T, I always stood with them just to spend time with them. So I think I kind of set the tone that I was there, but I still don't think Mr. T would do like Buddy's doing. Buddy doesn't know how to. Look, you got his respect. You can take the food. You're higher than him. He knows that. It doesn't mean you have to use it every time you can. I mean, he's reminding me of these freaking women that are respect my space. I'm strong. I'm powerful. I'm going to push you around. I'm going to make you. You're going to listen to me. You better not. And you better get. He touched me. And, you know, they're always coming up with reasons to yell and correct their horse. And that's kind of what Buddy is kind of doing. It's kind of a little irritating. So I got to keep my eye on them. And see, part of it is I think Ransom is so ready to move at the first sign of trouble. Somebody said that you should never feed alfalfa because they were told as a kid, come here, you. I don't like feeding the donkeys too much alfalfa because that is too rich for them. They don't need it. But the amount that I feed my horses is pretty limited. And it's not going to. People, if I was feeding them alfalfa three times a day, Moki came out to the tree. He's got a scratch on all his little trees. Look at that big old ant bed by Buddy's butt. I gotta come out here with some ant food to get rid of that. Scratch your little tree. I know somebody's gonna come out here and mark your territory. See, Buddy kinda I don't know if y'all saw that. Buddy told him to get back and he moved back. He's not being, he's think he's being slick and I don't see him. But if the other horse is seeing him, I'm seeing him. Hi, little Belle. There you go. I'll go get you guys some of your other stuff. So I talked to their owner and we're going to do their worming today, later on today. And I haven't watched them poop yet. As soon as I see them poop, because I wormed them yesterday, I'm going to go over and inspect their poop for dead worms. Buddy, you better chill out, boy. I know you wanted to push them. See how Buddy just slowly encroaches. And Ransom is slowly backing away. Now, if I stay out of this and I just fed one pile of hay, Ransom wouldn't be eating. Buddy would keep it all and just run him off. And then that's how you get aggressive horses and you get horses fighting for food, etc. Now, obviously I could put two piles out and then they wouldn't have to be close. But I kind of wanted them to be close because of So Buddy just got in his face and I'm gonna get in Buddy's face now and make him move out of my space. Would probably be better if I had a camera set up a little bit far away so you could see all my body and everything. So I'm gonna come in a little bit closer here, get my feet a little closer so we know we're all in each other's space. I mean, there's just no reason to fight like this other than an inexperienced leader like Buddy who doesn't know that, hey, it's all right if we eat together. I don't have to be pushing him all the time. And if I stood here every time I fed him, this problem would go away. But I don't stand here every time. So it's easier, like most people do with most horses, they take the easy path. So what do? I put out multiple piles and I let them just go kind of pick through it. My coffee's brewing. I haven't had my coffee yet, so. The donkey picking on that old man again, I'm gonna beat. Man, I'd be beating, I'd be wearing that freaking donkey out if I was over there. He picks on that old thing all the time. Every time he picked on him, I would be in his ass. He's a stallion, so he just, I mean, he's just got all this freaking domination energy. All the time. It's never on off. So when I'm close, they can eat close. No problems. Now I know there's going to be somebody out there that's going to say, Rick, I tried what you did and my horses knocked me down or they fought or one of them got bit or one of them got kicked. Well, then you didn't do it right because my guys aren't getting flipped over and they aren't biting each other. So when people call me and tell me they did the same thing I did and it didn't work and it was a disaster and it's my fault their horse got hurt, I'm like, really? Well, that's because you're an idiot. So I'm gonna walk away, see if Buddy gives him a little, tries to get pushy as I create some distance. So I created a pretty good distance here. I'll bring him some more hay. Hang on, baby girl, I'll give it to you. Hang on. Oh my goodness. All right, you can have a little bit too, you little I know those flies are bad. You can see the bot flies on her leg really good. See all those little gold dots? I don't know if the camera's picking it up. I don't know if Buddy has them or not. Look at all those on Buddy's leg. All those little gold dots right there? Little bot eggs. What are you doing, boy? You gonna come over and eat with the boys? You better stay away from that donkey. He might try to stomp you. You better stay away from that donkey. Ever since they moved in with dogs, he hasn't gone over their house, which is good. I'm glad. I like when he stays away from other people. So, again, did I need to do this? I know I'm going to have the people, Rick, you said stay out of it, and you punched Buddy, and you hit it. Damn horse barely felt what I did to him. I was putting pressure on. Normally, I go like this to get him to move. When he doesn't move, I increase pressure. So, Buddy, I saw that. You think I'm talking and not paying attention? I saw that. So I'm going to increase the distance. I increased my voice, kind of told him to back off. And I think this has given Ransom a little confidence to be able to not be so afraid of them. The problem with this is if I do this sporadically, I can end up making their relationship worse because Buddy knows he only has to tolerate him when he's with me. And then as soon as I'm not around, he'll retaliate. But horses don't think that way, retaliate. But Buddy may think I need to reassert my balance because he wasn't like a little moke kid and a donkey. Go get some more over here. If Moki gets too, Buddy, I saw that. You made him flinch. Knock it off. I don't know if y'all saw that or if I got it on camera. As soon as I was walking away, he kind of jumped back because Buddy gave him the evil eye when I got my distance and I wasn't paying attention. There was probably signs before that, but I wasn't paying attention. Buddy knows it. So that donkey's really, so I'm just going to go ahead and put another little second pile here. Well, he's really fixated on that cat. You gotta be careful with donkeys, they're kind of, protective. Buddy stopped eating because I got close because he didn't want to get in trouble again. Rick, you're being mean to Buddy. Look, I've been cutting him slack since he lost Mr. T. You didn't want to eat that stuff over there that I laid down with your little... All right, so I'm going to go ahead and as soon as I walk away, Moki will come with me. He's so little. I mean, it's just like, compared to freaking huge Buddy, it's just amazing the size difference when you get close to these guys. So he doesn't have any diarrhea, which is good. Usually if a horse has diarrhea, you'll see it kind of like dripping down here a little bit. So by lifting his tail, I can tell. And his tail's pretty relaxed, which is good. That's how horses lose their tail on freaking barbed wire. They shake their tail by it and it just rips out piece by piece. And I know I get a lot of people that are new here. Why do you have barbed wire? Cattle will not respect any wire but barbed wire. It's already up. To refence this place without barbed wire would cost within the tens or $20,000. And if I redid it, because he used to have cattle, and he has cattle, and he has cattle, and the people behind me have cattle, their cattle will tear down the fence if it's not barbed wire. So, that's the update. They're kind of eating. You notice they're kind of together, even though I walked away. Am I making it worse? See, Buddy didn't, I don't know if Buddy pinned his ears that time, or Ransom just overreacted. See, because Ransom's never been with a herd, I think he wants to be accepted that he doesn't know that I need to push back a little bit and I need to say, look, I'll respect you, but I'm not going to take your bullshit all the time. And I have not seen him push back except the first day when he kicked at Buddy when he was chasing him. That's the only time I've seen him kind of give any pushback. So if he gave more pushback, Buddy wouldn't do that. But he doesn't have the confidence because he's been along so long. All right. So I'm going to get out of here and Moki will follow me. You better stay away from that donkey, boy. You don't know what that crazy donkey's gonna do. He's got his eye on you. All right, we'll end that there. You guys are good boys. Buddy, Miss T, you're a good boy. Moki, too.